been very interesting to listen to you, but I have to be in another place at another place of town also at 6 o'clock to talk about arms and defense and security with a lot of people too, so that's why I had to go a bit earlier. I come from Sweden. I think that we have to, if we are trying to understand why the member states, they still sell arms to Saudi Arabia, we have to go back before the Arab Spring. And as I said, I come from Sweden. We have the common position on arms export. That is for all the countries in Europe. We are obliged to follow it. But then we have also our national legislations. And the Swedish legislation on arms export is stricter than the common position. And I will explain a bit more about that later on. But when before the Arab Spring, we can say that all countries in Europe, they felt that, yeah, there is a big market in the Middle East, especially Saudi Arabia, they're investing very much, and all of our countries wanted to be the ones who could sell the most, because we all have a big arms industry. There's a lot of job creation in these arms industries, and all the countries, they wanted to compete about this big market over there. And of course, if you follow the common position strictly, yes, you cannot sell to a country that do not respect human rights. But not all kinds of material you couldn't sell. Because if you can use the material you want, the military equipment that you want to sell against the own population, to oppress the own population, then it's not okay with the common position. But if you cannot use it against your own population, yes, you can. So if you send a submarine to Saudi Arabia, that's perfectly okay with the common position. But if you sell civilians equipment, for example, then that's another story. But in Sweden, then we have another point of view. To start with, our legislation is to forbid all kinds of arms export. So there is a prohibition as a base. But then you can do it if it's in the interest for the Swedish defense, for the Swedish security policy, and not against the Swedish foreign affairs policy. And our foreign affairs policy is built on human rights, democracy, and so on. So for us, it was not allowed to sell to Saudi Arabia according to our national law. But authorities, they tried all the time to circumvent, and they tried to be closer to the common position, and that, well, the other ones they do, so why shouldn't we? Then there was a big scandal once, because as they couldn't sell in reality anything, they tried to do a deal selling a service to Saudi Arabia. The service was to build an arms factory in Saudi Arabia to produce their own arms. Public opinion got to know about this because the media was very on and very hot on the issue, because they had understood something is going on. And because of that big scandal, the government, they decided to put a committee with all the parties represented in the Swedish parliament in that committee, to make the already strict law even stricter, so this would not be possible again, and that it would also include services. But when I was the one for the Green Party in that committee, and when I asked the person responsible in our authority that sells arms, how it was possible that we could sell arms to Saudi Arabia when it's forbidden to start with, and say, well, because for the defense industry, yes, we need to sell because we have a big industry and they need money. We need the people working there and so on. But for our security interest, I said, but for the security of Sweden, how is it possible that this you can say that it's okay to sell this factory to Saudi Arabia and say, well, for the Swedes, it's important to keep the harbors in Saudi Arabia open, oil transports and so on. So that was a security interest for Sweden. And then, but what about human rights, democracy? And then, well, the human rights abuses, they are not so bad. Yeah? And in Sweden, we are a country that really believe in women's rights and so on, and so we, of course, we said, hey, you are just, you don't comply with the Swedish law at all. So now we have, after 3 years, we had made a new proposal for a stricter law. It's even more strict when it comes to human rights than before, and it has also put a criteria, a specific criteria on democracy into it. When we started this committee, we were in opposition. But in the middle, we had elections, and the Greens came into government together with the Social Democrats. And we had also to renew the Memorandum of Understanding with Saudi Arabia. And we decided we would not renew it. And we did not. That was a big fight with Saudi Arabia in that place because of course, we had a lot of orders already on radar systems and so on, but of course, with the closing of the Memorandum of Understanding, it's much more difficult to sell new products to Saudi Arabia. Now that this law is going to pass the Swedish Parliament, because it has been looked upon and if we did everything right and so on, so now it can pass the Parliament very soon. And I'm very happy that this is going to be the case. But during this time, I left the Swedish Parliament and I came here into the European Parliament. And as a member of the CEDE committee, then I got this responsibility to also produce or to be the rapporteur for the control of the European exports. So in 2015, I had my first, in the end of 2015, I presented my first report on the weapons, the control of weapons export, European in general, and where I tried then to get the other groups here in the Parliament also in telling that we need a stricter interpretation of the common position. And that was possible because of what is happening in the and also because we now see also terrorist attacks in the European Union, and they are many times linked to the Middle East. So of course here in the Parliament we do see the way the world is changing and we have to adapt. The problem is when we come to the Council, because there we have the Member States and they are so stuck in their ways of selling arms in the traditional way of selling arms, so we will have a big fight with them. But anyway, the first report I made, there we took one first step, I think, in a stricter way. After that, I got a phone call from Saudi Arabia. They wanted to see me. And as they know I come from Sweden, they also say, well, there is a women delegation from Saudi Arabia coming here and we would like to see you, because they thought that maybe I would say no otherwise. So I met this group, and there was a man and one woman and a lot of other people around them. And the man was talking very much until I said, well, I also want to hear what the ladies would like to tell me. But it was a good discussion and so on. But they, of course, they knew about my position on the export. They also knew about my position on the situation in Yemen. We also had a resolution on Yemen in 2015, and so they told me that yes, we went to Yemen because this is self defense. So this was self defense for Saudi Arabia. Okay, we didn't come along really, we do not agree, but anyway, now, this year, I had my second, no, then after the first report, we have a new resolution also on Yemen, where we managed to get in also that the parliament pronounces itself in favor of an embargo against Saudi Arabia. Because we can do that, as the council could decide upon that. It's more difficult to use the common position, especially when it comes to human rights, because of the reasons I told you before. It depends on what you use the military equipment for. But anyway, when the country is in war somewhere, it's also forbidden to sell arms. But anyway, the countries, the member states, they are continuing to sell arms to Saudi Arabia. So what could the council do? Yes, they could have an embargo against Saudi Arabia. And so this came into the resolution. It was a rather big work to get it into it, because not all of the party groups are in favor of it. But we got it in. Then we have remembered Mogherini several times about our wish for an arms embargo. We made our, I made my second report on the control of weapons export, and there we put it in again. And we got again the parliament to stand behind the wish for weapons or for a weapons embargo against Saudi Arabia. And now we follow it up. We are going to send a letter to Mogherini again, where, with several of the group's party leaders. So the ALDE group is in it, we are in it, the socialists are in, the left-wingers, they are in. We don't believe we will get the right-wing parties into that letter, but anyway, I believe we will be a majority in the parliament, asking Mogherini to really start the work on a weapons embargo. This is a long process. It takes years to change the mentality, and there's so much money into this, in weapons export. But at the same time, also in the Commission and in the Council, we are also looking upon now, because we have so much extra weapon systems in the European Union. We don't need it. We have an overcapacity of weapons in the European Union. And we have to reduce in some way. Or we should not compete so much with each other. We should produce what we need for our own defense, and not just producing to sell to other countries, because that can also be used against us. Because if we sell something to a country somewhere, and suddenly that country is no longer in peace, and these weapons, they can be used against us. That is also one of the reasons why it has been easier to get the parliament also to stand behind the embargo or restrict the control of the weapons. So we have a long way to go still, but we're on the way. And I think that we in the parliament, we are leading this fight. The parliament in the European Union, some member states, as Sweden, but also other member states. Because in this work, I've been talking to this organization, COARM, where all the member states, they gather and they discuss different ways of interpreting the common position and so on. And I think really that many of the member states, they are on our side. So I think it's not impossible, but it will be very difficult. Especially we have the problem with France, Germany, and Great Britain. Yeah? Those are the biggest problems when it comes to weapons export, really, for the whole of Europe. But I can assure you that we do everything that we can in this parliament, and that we also have a very good cooperation, ALDE and the Greens. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.